Okay, so I think it's our sixth session, and let's wait for some viewers to come inside. No. I think sixth.
Yeah, I think sixth too.
Alright,
okay, so viewers have come.
Welcome back to Sunday Fun Day. I'm Sharanya.
And I'm Radhika.
And today we have with us Jeevan. He's a professional international player, and this is a very different sport. We've never actually involved a sport like this. It's tennis, and we're really excited to...
Has he come?
Yes, he has. Yeah. You can invite him. We're really excited to have this session with him today. Yes.
Okay.
And join.
We've become pros at this.
I guess, yes. Okay, wait.
Oh, jeez. My camera is the wrong way. Hi. Sorry, my camera is the wrong side. There it is. Hi, girls.
Hi.
How are you?
We're fine. How are you?
I'm good. I'm so excited for this live with you guys. How old are you all, Sharanya, Radhika?
I'm 13.
And I'm 9. I'm going to turn 10.
You guys are rock stars.
Thank you.
Nice. That's awesome. That's awesome. So what's going on? How has your week been? What have you all been up to?
Online classes, the usual routine.
I am tennis.
Sorry?
Yeah, tests have started as well. Our exams and tests. Yeah.
Tell me about Sunday Fun Day. I'm really curious. Tell me a little bit about Sunday Fun Day. What happens on the show?
So we get guests like you, famous personalities, and we interview them. And we get to know more about the sport.
Okay. Okay. That's awesome.
And we also involve the viewers.
And I'm ready for all your interview questions. I've been warming up. I'm ready. Before we start, can I just request one thing? I just finished training, so I just have one small request. Can you give me 5 seconds to just quickly put one Fast Enough tablet into my drink? It doesn't take long, right? It doesn't take long. Mm-hmm. There, okay. I'm ready now.
Okay. So let's get started for today's session.
So in today's session of Sunday Fun Day, we have a very special guest. Let me introduce you to a very witty, cool, and most importantly, a professional Indian tennis player. Jeevan, formerly known as Jeevan.
That's right.
He won a doubles title with Rohan Bopanna at the 2017 ASL Chennai Open. He broke into the ABP 100 doubles ranking in 2016 and was ranked 81st after winning the historic finals. He's won so many medals that I can't keep telling them, otherwise I won't be able to start with the question.
It's such an honor to have you here.
How are you all so good at these interviews? I'm amazed. I keep trying to do these things, but you have to give me some tips, some techniques. How do you all do this? You guys are naturals.
Your lives are better
than
ours.
Your lives are amazing. Oh, viewers, please do tune in to Game Night with Jee at 9 p.m. today.
That's right.
Daily official. So, any the questions?
I'm ready for your questions. I'm ready, Sharanya. I'm ready, Radhika. Okay, let's do this.
Okay.
When you were a kid, what was one thing you liked doing? And can you tell us about your early days?
Okay. When I was a kid, which was not too long ago, the one thing I liked doing was hitting tennis balls against the wall. So if anything became very, very stressful, like exams and things like that, and I wasn't sure and I couldn't keep thinking about it, then the first thing that I would do is go to the wall and start hitting balls against the wall, and it would automatically de-stress me. So that's my most favorite memory as a child.
So tennis was a stress buster for you?
Definitely. Definitely a stress buster. I remember playing a lot against the wall at home when I was both your girls' age.
Oh, okay. So you started pretty early.
Yeah, I held a tennis racket for the first time when I was, I want to say, 3.5 or 4 years old. First time.
Oh,
Yeah. Yeah.
how were
Yeah.
you
That.
introduced to tennis?
My family, actually, my grandfather played a big role in introducing me to tennis, and my mom also. And my uncle, he used to play tennis a lot, so there was a little bit of a curiosity to start playing tennis. So yeah, my grandfather, my mom, I'd say my uncle, everyone, like as a family, you know, we all went to the local tennis academy and we all started playing. And then as we kept playing, they said that, you know, I'm left-handed and I may be pretty decent because I was able to hit the targets correctly against the wall. So I just continued to pursue it even after 4 or 5 years old.
So it started like a family thing.
Yeah, that's what it started as a family thing. My sister's 5 years older than me, so even she went to the same academy, and we all started together. So we all kept playing together, and it was just a bunch of fun things to do, you know. We just kept having fun playing tennis. After school was over, we'd go to the tennis courts and play for like 3 hours, and then that's what made it fun. Hi,
Okay.
Sarvajit.
What has tennis taught you?
Man, tennis has taught me a lot of things, a lot of things. But if I had to say a few really, really important lessons that tennis can teach you is you have to learn to deal with setbacks. You have to always keep working hard, and you need to be able to, yeah, I would say the most important thing is you learn to deal with not winning all the time and learning to deal with those setbacks. That's the most important thing tennis teaches you.
Oh, okay. What are the best and worst moments in your career?
My best moment. You wanted me to say the best moment or the worst moment first?
We'll start with the good ones.
We start with the good. Thanks. We'll start with a happy note. The
The
best moment in my career, I was thinking it would probably be when I won my first international tournament after graduating from college. I really, really enjoyed that. That was a really big moment for me because I knew I could continue playing for many years once I won my first ITF tournament. But I have to also say winning Chennai Open in my hometown, that was a very, very big moment in my career with Rohan. So shout out to Rohan for coming and winning Chennai with me. That was also a very, very special memory.
Okay. And
My
worst.
worst moment, you asked me my worst, no? I'm trying to think. I was thinking about this. What could be a bad moment playing tennis? Because it's such a great sport to play. And I'm just thinking, I can't really think of any bad moments. But if I had to pick, I would say 2012, I got injured and I wasn't able to play for around 2, 3 months because of a little tear in my stomach that I had. It took 2, 3 months off. And I was doing pretty well. And yeah, I'd say that was the worst moment while playing. I don't like getting injured, obviously. And just not being able to do anything, and the doctors and all saying you shouldn't even hit on the wall, just sit for bed rest for like 2, 3 months. That was a very tough thing for me.
Right. Since there are no sporting events this year, what keeps you going?
What keeps me going? I love the fact that I can spend time with my family. I'm always traveling a lot for my tournaments, right? I'm traveling like around I'd say 30, 40 weeks a year, which is a lot of time away from home. So now I'm finally getting to spend time with my sister, my mom, my wife, and we're all together for the last 6 months here in Pondicherry at our resort. It's called K Resort. So we've been here for a long time now. So that's the best part about it. It's been keeping me going. I also keep training. I'm still in shape and I'm waiting for the right time to start playing tennis tournaments again. For me personally, that hasn't come yet. I'm just going to wait a little longer. But for fun, to keep myself entertained, I, like you said, will try to be like you girls and host some Insta lives once a week.
They're really fun. We really love watching them.
Oh, yeah? So I'm having a show today between tennis versus gymnastics. Who do you think is going to
Funny
win?
about gymnastics.
You like gymnastics? So Meghna Reddy is coming on the show tonight. She's India's best rhythmic gymnast.
Okay,
And
which
she's from your
one?
town, I think. Yeah, so she's coming tonight at 9 o'clock to be a part of it. Really?
Yes.
Nice, nice. So it should be a lot of fun.
Family's role in your career?
Very. If I had to rate it, I would say 9 out of 10. It's really, really important that the family gives you your support to play because you girls know what I'm talking about. At your age, you want to do a lot of fun stuff, right? Nobody wants to do boring things. So the fact that my family made tennis a fun thing growing up, that my sister, my cousins, we all went to the courts together and played together. We really enjoyed that aspect. The fact that we were all together after tennis session was over, we would go to the canteen and get something to eat. So the whole experience was a lot of fun. Hey, Megs is here. What's up, Megs? I hope you're warming up for tonight.
Viewers, if you have any questions, feel free to chat in the chat box below.
No, I just saw a couple of friends. I wanted to say hi, but I love all your questions. You guys put in a lot of effort to making these questions. They're really good. I really like it.
Yeah, we spend our weekends, we read about
Yeah.
athletes, and we love the story behind everyone.
How many episodes have you all done until now?
I think five. I think you are at six. He's at six. So five
Wow.
until now.
And you're enjoying it. You guys are enjoying it.
Yes. We love
Yeah.
interacting with people like you.
Only
Yeah.
before that, tennis is much like in the stomach, but or else it's really fun.
That's good. That's good. It's great to see you all do this. That's awesome.
How do you build your mental strength?
How do I build my mental strength? I think it comes naturally well with playing tennis, because you travel so many weeks, and like I said earlier, you deal with a lot of setbacks. There's only one person that wins a tournament at the end of every week. So you naturally, the game itself is designed where you need to be quite mentally strong, and you might have an idea of how you want a certain week to go. But the way you build it is, I would say, just keep at it. Like they say, you keep knocking on the door, keep knocking on the door, and eventually something will break through and you will have a successful week. So you build strength by staying positive and knocking on the door every time, because the last thing you want is to, have a regret that, oh, I could have tried a little harder, and then nothing, and then you might have been literally just a couple of steps from reaching a goal and you wouldn't have known about it. So yeah, you build mental strength by working hard and knocking on the door every time. Hi, Pura.
Is there something you keep telling yourself to, during the competition to, prepare yourself?
A mantra.
Mantra? No, mantra. But since Purav Raja, one of the best doubles players in India, has joined us on the chat, I'll actually tell you a mantra that he uses, which is very, very good. Okay, I'm stealing it from his book right now. So he has and I hope he's not upset that I'm telling it on an Insta Live. But his big secret. This is his big secret. Are you ready?
Yes, we are.
Okay, Purav Raja's big secret is when he goes into a match, he goes in with the mentality of it doesn't matter if you win or lose, so who cares, just play. It's a sport, you have to enjoy playing the sport, and that's the most important thing. And that automatically calms you down. And I really like that mantra. So if I had to pick one, I'd say enjoy what you do and keep going with that. He's laughing.
Yeah. I think Rohan Bopanna is watching it.
Oh, he is? He's in New York right now for the US Open. So you girls want to wish him good luck for the US Open?
Yes, good luck. All the best. We'll be watching you on
Yeah, I'm
whatever.
sure we all will be watching. Just stay safe, Rohan. Stay safe. Stay in the bubble.
What's your diet like?
My diet? I don't eat food. No more
What?
food. I'm kidding, I'm kidding. No. So when it comes to diet, I always say pay attention to what you like to eat and what you know is not overboard with making yourself feel bad that you're missing out on the things you like. So to make it simple, I don't really want to say the word diet, but I try to say pay attention to your body and then understand what works for you, where you feel good the next day, and keep using those things. And I would strongly suggest people take a test to figure out what kind of food groups work for your own body, because there's not one size fits all with diet. So I would say pay attention to it, go to a nutritionist, find out what works, and everyone is different with diet.
Okay. You kind of got me there when I asked you the question.
Yeah, I do eat. I do eat. Honest, to be, if you're being very honest, I had a nice big pizza last night. And I know it makes me happy. So if it makes me happy, it must be good for me, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. In moderation.
Mm-hmm. What is one food you love just eating every single day?
If I had to pick, I have to pick pizzas. I'm sorry. I just said it already. It's pizzas. I can have a pizza any time of the day. Hot, cold, doesn't matter. What about you girls? What do you like? What do you like? What's your favorite?
Homemade pasta.
I like many homemade things.
No, but you have to pick. You have to pick. She's already picked homemade pasta.
I love my mom's pasta.
Nice.
I love my mom's puliyogare.
Wow. So yeah. Mom cooking, basically everything that mom is cooking works.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pretty much.
I got it.
Mom cooking is the best.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Can you guys see me? Yeah. Okay. Good.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I agree. My sister is saying you girls are the cutest hosts by far. That's my sister Swapna.
Oh, thank you. Do you like playing mixed doubles? And if so, who do you like to play it with?
Who do I like to play doubles with? Is that the question?
Mixed doubles.
Mixed doubles. Ooh, googly. If I had to pick a mixed doubles partner, it has to be Indian or it can be anyone?
Anyone.
I'm ready with my answer. She's actually in your comment section right now.
Oh.
Her name is Neha Tripathi. She's my wife.
Oh.
She's a golfer. She's a golfer. She's like one of the best golfers in India.
Oh, wow.
And she's into tennis. She's been playing tennis every evening with me for like half an hour. So she likes playing tennis. So I'll play with her.
Oh, that's amazing.
We'll ask her to come and you interview her also one of these times.
That would be great.
I know. That'd be fun. I'd love to watch that.
If you had to choose any mixed doubles, from the world, not only India, from the world, who would it be? Would it be Rohan?
Yeah, why not? I mean, Rohan and I have won Chennai Open. Since you've given me a hint on Rohan, I'll say, yeah, Rohan. But if you want me to pick anyone who's not Indian, I'll pick a player called Jack Sock. I'll take Jack Sock. He's a very, very good doubles player from America.
And why exactly?
Because I have a feeling, because it's an international partner, there must be like a big prize. So since there's a big prize, I want like a good partner, so I'll pick him. But if it's like a fun competition, then I'll play with like a celebrity. I'm thinking I'll ask Will Smith. I'll play with Will Smith. Yeah, he's a great. Yeah, I'll pick him. I'll go with him.
He plays tennis.
I'll teach him because it's anyway for fun, no? So I'll play with him.
We will love to watch you both play.
Yeah, if anybody, for all the people that are watching, knows how I can get in touch with Will Smith for tennis in a doubles competition, let me know.
How do you see tennis in India grow over these past years?
Could you repeat the question? Sorry.
How do you see tennis in India grow over these past years?
I think we made a lot of good improvements, no? In the last 10 years. We've seen a bunch of players breaking into the top 100 in tennis. There's a kid called Sumit Nagal. Sumit Nagal is in the main draw for US Open singles. He's going to be playing his match Tuesday, Indian time, around 8:30 in the first round of a Grand Slam. So that's great. So obviously, we wish him all the best. And there's a bunch of players right now who are doing really well on the ATP tour, like Prajnesh, Yuki Bambri is coming back, and a lot of good singles players. You know, we have Mukund also, who's a young guy that's coming up. So a lot of really cool tennis players to follow on the tennis tour who are doing well. And doubles, I don't need to say much. We have fantastic players for the last so many years. So I'm happy with the way these guys have been able to perform. But if things need to improve and we want to see even more people come, then I would think we need a little bit more help from the grassroots level. Kids your age, I want them to start playing tennis more. And we need to figure out how we can get you all on a tennis court. Because then we will find more and more world-class players when the young kids start playing tennis more. Okay. That's the way forward.
You already mentioned that there was an advantage to being left-handed. So could you tell us what the advantage is?
But if I tell you, then I lose my advantage. No, I'm joking. No, the advantage is there weren't that many lefties, I guess, growing up and stuff. So it's a different type of spin that they put on the ball. So do you girls watch cricket?
Yeah, kind of.
Little bit. Okay, fine, little bit. I'll say that suddenly you're playing a fast bowler all the time, and then suddenly Harbhajan Singh comes and starts to put a different spin, then it feels different, right? So that's a little bit of an advantage you have growing up with being a left-hander. But the fact is, everyone gets used to spin bowling, fast bowling, everything when they get older. So it's an advantage to start, but as you get older, it becomes pretty even.
Okay, I'm a left-hander, so I was really kicked when I got to know that you were 1-2.
Oh yeah, nice. What's your favorite shot? Backhand, forehand, serve? What do you like?
I don't play any hand sports. I love to run actually. So.
Oh wow! I used to do a lot of athletics when I was growing up. Also, that's what I really enjoyed. I used to run for my school 100, 200, and long jump, and I would obviously be part of the relay team also. So athletics was actually my favorite. I really liked doing all those things growing up.
In your childhood, did you play any other sports?
I mean, you play tennis.
Yeah, apart from tennis, we all used to meet up and play a little bit of football at the end of the tennis session. So that was fun. But I really think that for my coordination and stuff, athletics was the main thing, like I was telling you. I liked running a lot. I liked running fast, whether it was a long distance or, you know, explosive things like jumping and all, like anything you do where we go to that big ground. No, in a big ground, you can always meet people, hang out. I like that a lot, so I would keep mixing it up there. Everything except high jump. I didn't like high jump, maybe because I'm not very tall, so I didn't like high jump.
Do you still run?
I do run, obviously to stay in shape, not to break any records. I run to stay in shape for tennis.
Do you like those runs? Do you like the slow endurance?
Yes, I like them all. I like the idea of setting a time limit and then trying to achieve it, and then everything about it. You're with yourself for like 30 minutes, you're able to collect your own thoughts, how you want to plan the rest of your day or the next day. Everything about running I really, really enjoy. So that is my go-to fitness thing. I would prefer running over cycling or over any other type of cardio thing. Running is my favorite, which a lot of people may not like, but as long as I'm able to run, I enjoy it a lot.
Okay. Do we move to the most fun part of today's session?
The rapid fire question.
Sorry, I'm laughing because my mom has written individual champion. Because I won an individual championship when I was in third standard in school. She's still very proud of that.
That's nice.
Okay, what is the most fun part? What is the most fun part? Tell me.
So rapid fire questions. So basically how it works is we're gonna ask you questions with
Sorry, I was just playing around with the filter, I got distracted. Tell me. Okay, you're gonna ask me questions.
Okay.
So we're going to ask you questions as you can.
As fast as I can. Okay, rapid fire. I'm ready.
Okay, start.
A dish that you can eat every day.
Pizzas. Oh, pizzas.
Yeah. 3 things on your bucket list.
Going to see the Northern Lights, then traveling around the world for a vacation with my wife and family, and maybe like for a year. Another thing on my bucket list, what else do I really want to do? Traveling, see these places. I don't want to go on a cruise. Fine. I want to buy apartments all over the world so I can live in all these great cities and just live for free everywhere.
So every time you just come to that city, you can just stay there.
Yeah, exactly. Why simply go to the hotel and you won't really enjoy? So I'd rather, yeah, Purav, golf. When we go for the world travel, we'll make time for golf. Yeah. I'll try to buy apartments everywhere. Since it's a dream, I might as well hope for it.
So whenever you go, there's a house waiting for you.
Yeah, that's what. I feel like I'm part of that city for that trip, you know. That's what. If I stay in a hotel, I feel like I've always traveled and stayed in the hotel, so then I feel like a tourist. But if I have a house, then I feel like I'm part of that city for at least that time. Yeah.
Adikan,
okay, you're all welcome. We can go and go for a run also. We can go jogging.
Okay. One word to describe yourself.
I'll go with resilient. Resilient.
Okay. What does that mean?
That means I basically would like to find a way to do things even if it's difficult. I'll find a way to go through a tough time and make it happen.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your favorite Tamil movie star?
Talaivar Rajnikanth. You know Rajnikanth?
We kind of guessed it. Yes, we love his movies.
Yeah, how you guessed it?
I don't know. It's default.
Nice. Yeah, I'm Rajnikanth for sure. I'll go with Talaivar. Okay. Number one.
He's amazing.
Nice.
No one can beat him.
I agree with you completely.
Your favorite TV show?
My all-time favorite is Seinfeld. Seinfeld. Oh. It's a comedy show that was there before Friends, before How I Met Your Mother. Oh. Now I sound really old, but Seinfeld was my favorite. Yeah.
One thing you cannot live without.
I'll go with chocolate. I like chocolate.
Wow.
Yeah.
Your dream destination.
Dream destination. I don't even. I don't know. I have to pass. I don't. It's too many. It's too difficult to pick. I don't know what to pick.
Okay. Top 3 or the rest of the world?
I was thinking of anything along the coastlines of California. All those places are amazing. Then I thought about the Bahamas for some reason. And then I would also say Hawaii. I guess anything where it's like beach and sunny, like beaches and sunny. I like all that. Yeah.
Okay. We have one last question. If you had one wish, what would it be?
One what?
Wish that you could get.
If I could get one wish, I would, is it for me? Like this wish is only for me?
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'll say I'll act in a movie with Rajnikanth.
Wow, that's amazing. I think we've come to an end to the session. We want to talk more, but then we run out of questions as well. So.
What is your favorite Rajnikanth dialogue? Do you guys have a favorite?
I remember this. I forgot this one, but he said something in almost every movie.
Yeah.
I loved one too in Kala.
Okay, what is it? Yeah, Kala, great movie. Okay,
Yes.
I will tell you one. You girls understand Tamil or no?
Kinda.
Little bit. Little bit.
Yeah.
I'll give you one dialogue. Once I say it, then you should also say it, okay?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Don't mind our accents, though.
No, I definitely won't mind your accent. But give me one second to get ready. நான் ஒரு தடவை சொன்னா 100 தடவை சொன்ன மாதிரி.
I don't think we can repeat it, but I definitely love when you said it.
So that means if I say something once, it's like I've said it 100 times. So try it. நான் ஒரு தடவை சொன்னா 100 தடவை சொன்ன மாதிரி.
You say first.
Go for it.
No.
சரண்யா, நான்
Could you repeat it? Could you
ஒரு
please repeat it?
தடவை சொன்னா
ஒரு தடவை சொன்னா.
ஒரு தடவை சொன்னா.
100 தடவை சொன்ன மாதிரி.
100 தடவை சொன்ன மாதிரி. I think we're killing someone.
No, you nailed it. You nailed it. It was perfect. My friend Elvin Anthony just joined us. He will tell you that you said it perfectly. You said it
Wow.
perfect.
I hope. Even
if we are Tamilians, we don't really speak
That
that
doesn't
much Tamil.
matter. As long as you learn all the Rajnikanth dialogues, no problem.
Okay. We will.
We do English Tamil. Can we say Tamil? Tamil we don't
Yeah.
really say in English.
Okay, fine. No problem.
Okay,
Yeah,
so
see,
you
all
learned
my friends
about
like it. My mom is clapping. Elvin is saying too good. So he really likes the way you it. It was perfect. Thank you so much for having me on Sunday Fun Day, girls. I really enjoyed it.
We do. Yeah, we
Yeah?
loved it.
Really, that's good. That's good.
We
Yeah?
had a great time.
Awesome. Thank you so much for having me on your show. I really appreciate
Yeah.
it.
Also, viewers, don't forget to tune in to Game Night with G only on Indian Tennis Daily Official at 9 p.m.
That's right.
today.
That's right. Are you girls going to be watching? Are you supporting tennis or gymnastics? Tennis or
Gymnastics
gymnastics?
or tennis? Probably. I'm just in it to watch
Okay,
and
fine,
have
fine.
fun.
Thanks a lot, girls. Bye,
Okay,
everyone.
bye.
Bye.